house. And I am so honored, thrilled, proud to introduce our speaker today. She is honestly one of the most amazing people that I know, that I have ever known. She is a walking, talking, living miracle. And she is a big part of this community. She's doing her work. I'm trying not to give anything away. You, no matter what she shares with you today, you really can't get the full impact of her story without reading her book. I'm not trying to push the book, I'm just telling you that you would never know, never guess what this woman has been through. And I'm so glad she's here. Please welcome Angela Leigh Tucker.
Here at July 2008, Angela 1 died, and Angela 2 was born. These two are very different people. Angela 1 was a multitasking vice president of a team of PR professionals. She was known as the Queen of Karaoke. It was a bonding strategy with clients, very effective. She was bringing home the bacon and frying it up in a pan. Love me some bacon. Angela 2 finds multitasking difficult. She sleeps more and sometimes gets lost in the subway. But she's a rock star and still loves bacon. By acknowledging these two selves, it allows me to stop trying to return to the shoes of Angela 1 and allows me to wholly love and inhabit Angela 2. I know everyone in this room has faced a significant challenge somewhere along the way in life, whether job loss, a breakup, a divorce, financial troubles, health challenges, or simply surviving in New York City. Take a moment to think what this experience was for you. I'd now like to invite you to reconsider this date, the pivotal turning point in your life, as your rebirth day. After all, it's an important part of who you are today. A number of the new faces here this morning are members of what I refer to as my recovery team, the long line of angels, many of whom were strangers, that came together to help rebuild my life. This includes paramedics, doctors, therapists, attorneys, widows and widowers, fellow widows and widowers, members of the Brain Injury Association of New York State, which I'm now the proudly new elected New York City chairperson. Yay. And members of my beloved brain injured family. Many more who have touched my life merely by being in it. One person who could not be here today is author Bill Ramsey from North Carolina. He earlier released this year a book titled Me Now, Who Next, which is the story of my recovery from his point of view. With challenges comes change, and change isn't necessarily easy. When I attended a service at Unity Village Chapel at Unity Village outside of Kansas City, Reverend Aaron McCabe demonstrated an exercise that demonstrated how uncomfortable change can be. Let's try it now. I invite you to find a seat in a section you've never sat in before, next to someone you've never met before. This includes you, Sassy. Can we have the house light up, please? And for those of you who are upstairs who'd like the dark, do the best you can. Ready, set, go.
Thank you.
take a moment to introduce yourself. Retreats with many of you, I've strengthened my spiritual muscles. One of my favorite courses is the 4T's Prosperity Class. I see many of my former 4T's prayer group members here now.
Hey!
Hey, girl! The last 4T's goal I set was, I am an effective advocate for those affected by brain injury. I am proud to say that I'm serving this community now. As we say in unity, this stuff works. Probably the most powerful and important spiritual muscle I've developed is my prayer practice. I still receive outpatient therapy at NYU Lingo, and of all the therapies I've completed, my prayer practice is probably the most important part of my healing. I have a prayer partner, and we pray 5 days a week. Some of you may know him. His name is Britt Hall. Yeah. Britt, thank you for helping me manifest this opportunity and develop this talk. I love you like the brother I've never had. Thank you. Our prayer partnership is very sacred. Our prayer partnership had been under the radar for a number of years, but we recently came out of the prayer closet with this month's issue of Daily Word, when the editor asked us to write the feature articles. Mine is titled, Prayer Saved My Life, which it truly has done. Before I close, I'd like to share an excerpt from the book I was asked to write, or the chapter in the book I was asked to write, Me Now, Who Next? There is a hardworking guardian angel who makes this journey bearable, and there isn't a day that goes by that I haven't felt rich at my side, including right now. Sometimes this presence is made obvious through songs that happen to play around me, like the time his favorite Del Nitri song came on while I was strapped into a treadmill at physical therapy. I later discovered the obscure song, Tell Her, on my laptop under music Bridge uploaded onto my computer. There's occasionally a subtle sensation. I know I'm not alone in the room and standing there by myself. When someone loses a person they love, that loss is clear, and there is something tangible to grieve. In many ways, it's easier to grieve a death than it is to lose a part of yourself. The reality is I've lost more than a young husband, a career, and a lifestyle. I'd venture to guess that this loss of self is the most upsetting loss for most brain injury survivors. We're all trying to figure out how to live as a different person. How do we accept our new selves and gain the acceptance from others as this new self? We've lost so much of who we were and are approaching our lives as if entrepreneurs. And yet, those losses do not have to mean the end of the world. I quickly broke the habit of referring to myself in the past tense, or the old me, because I didn't like how it sounded or felt. Returning to the old me would be taking steps backwards anyway. So I began focusing on the new me. I've wondered why my recovery is going so well, and I thought maybe it's the type or location of my brain injury. But my former occupational therapist told me that my injuries are significant and not localized. The real payoff is coming because I do what I'm told. Sure, there are days when I have to force myself to exercise, when I'd rather take a nap. But there's an internal flame, or a guardian angel, who gives me reason to work. The benefits are becoming obvious, and the daily improvements are very fulfilling. I want you to experience this recovery too. It's within every survivor's reach. I'd like to add, it's within the reach of all of you. Every survivor has a story of horrific tragedy. Rather than dwelling on the how we got our brain injury and what we can no longer do as a result, consider what gifts this injury has given you. What can you do now that you could not have done before the accident? For example, these days I cannot multitask. Before, I always had 2, 3, or 10 things on my plate. Now, when you're talking to me, you get my full and undivided attention. To my benefit and that of those around me, my new ability to provide my undivided attention is a gift. To those who helped you, as I've already shared, I refer to these doctors, nurses, paramedics, therapists, psychologists, support groups, family and friends as my recovery team. I make a point of telling them how valuable their contribution is. Thank you to those of you who are here today. We're all mixed up. This is especially true of your professional medical therapy team. The nurse on life flight, Jenna Canavan, told me, "Thank you so much. It's miracles like you that make our job worth every moment." To all those who have touched my life, physically, emotionally, and those I've never met but who helped me in prayer, I thank you from a place deeper than my heart. The time, talent, and money you invested to save and restore my life were not wasted. I refuse to believe that this was an accident. God is not cruel. God has a bigger plan, and I anticipate what the adventure that lies ahead. I believe in the power of affirmation. Many of you might not venture a guess at the outcome of my story. At the risk of spoiling the surprise, let me tell you the end. I have very clear affirmations of the direction of my life. Number one, I will become an effective advocate for brain injury survivors and their families. That's already happening. Number two, I will sing again. And number three, I will find the second love of my life. Yes. This challenge you've experienced or may be going through right now, remember that each day is not only sacred, it's brand new. So happy birthday to you. Yeah.